डिक्टेशन स्टार्ट नाउ। इट इज अ प्लेजर फॉर मी टू बी हेयर फॉर द 7th कन्वोकेशन ऑफ द इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी हैदराबाद। दिस ओकेजन इज अ डबल सेलिब्रेशन एज इट कोइंसाइड्स विद द 10th एनिवर्सरी ऑफ द ओपनिंग ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूट। Let me begin by congratulating the IIT Hyderabad community for these landmarks for the graduating students today. Is a special moment is the result of years of hard work and dedication on your part and on the part of your teachers and professors as well as your families. The energy and enthusiasm of youth combined with a solid foundation is a very effective combination. It can take an individual very far. As fresh IIT graduates, you are entering a world and an India packed with opportunities. There is so much you can do and so much you can achieve for yourselves, for your families, for society at large, particularly for those less fortunate. Then you please dream big and aim high and please take a risk. The time to do it is now. Like individuals, institutions are very dependent on decisions taken in their formative years. IIT Hyderabad is a young. It is only 10 years old. It is too is defined by energy and enthusiasm and has built a solid foundation. Today you have 2500 students, one in five of them being a young man, woman. The institute has a strong postgraduate program with 30% of students pursuing a PhD. These are commendable figures, but the question is what next? The road you take today will determine your future, not just for the next few years, but perhaps for the rest of the century. That may sound like an overstatement, but do consider some of the world's major universities or even the older IITs. Your peer institutions, their achievements over several decades have been shaped by the trajectory they took in their earliest days. As a second generation IIT, it is important that you borrow from as well as learn from the models of the past. Conditions are different from the 1950s and 1960s. India has changed. Technology and the very discipline of engineering have evolved. Our aspirations are no longer limited to the heavy industrial base that we created 6 decades ago. Rather, IIT Hyderabad has to remain relevant to the 4th industrial revolution that will write the script of the 21st century. The new centers include the Center for Cyber Physical System and Internet of Things and the Fabulous Chip Design Incubator and the other initiatives that fall under the umbrella of the TIC Foundation. Collaborative research is being carried out in areas of widespread utility such as 5G technology, affordable housing and information networks for natural disaster mitigation and recovery with leading international universities and R&D agreements with Japanese industrial corporation are also worthy of appreciation. Ladies and gentlemen, members of the faculty and dear students, the best scientific universities and institutions of learning are not just teaching shops or degree factories. Increasingly, they are sources of innovation and incubators of technology and technology-driven startups. The knowledge ecosystem of public investments in science, academic institutions and universities research, laboratories, commercial applications and private enterprise has an almost magical potential. Its best example is, of course, Silicon Valley in the United States. At the core of Silicon Valley are basic science and technology campuses and their talented faculty and students. This IIT has been set up in a city and in a metropolitan area where several elements for such an ecosystem already exist. IIT Hyderabad, in a sense, is the element that completes the picture. Hyderabad has a long tradition of scientific discovery and application. In the 19th century, Ronald Rose, who won the Nobel Prize for medicine for identifying the mosquito that transmitted malaria, did pioneering work here. After independence, Hyderabad became a location of industrial manufacture. It saw vigorous and farsighted investment by the public sector and then the private sector. Gradually, the city's reputation grew as a research center. Before coming here, I called for details from the CSIR, the Department of Science and Technology, the Department of Biotechnology, the Department of Atomic Energy, the DRDO and the ISRO. Between these institutions, I am told there as many as 19 research facilities and laboratories in Hyderabad. I have not even mentioned the private sector. Hyderabad-based companies are engaged in cutting-edge research and manufacture of biopharmaceuticals and vaccines, and separately, in the field of information technology, the true measure of IIT Hyderabad cannot be restricted to grade point averages, campus placement, and number of published papers. No doubt, all of those are important, but please do not limit your ambitions. Please break out of soils and please encourage others to break out of silos. India will judge your success by the vitality and the output you can ensure for not just yourself, but for the entire Hyderabad knowledge ecosystem.